Hi, it's Bianca here. Welcome to a new tutorial. And today I'm going to explain how to crochet this cushion cover. Super easy to make. I'm going to explain to you step by step. But first I will show you what you need for this cushion. You need a cushion cover of 50 by 50 centimeters. I have one with a zipper in a solid color. You can buy these anywhere. Then we need yarn. I use yarn cut on 8 from Scheepjes. You need 3 balls in total. The crochet hook that we need is a 3 mm. Then you need also a scissor and a needle to weave all the ends in and to make invisible joints. We also need machine thread and a small needle with a sharp point. This is for around the large square when it's ready to sew it on the cushion cover. So let's start making this square. We make 16 in total of it. We start with a magic circle on the hook. I make that magic circle a little bit smaller. I find that easier to work in it. We start with a chain 3. It's 1, 2 and 3. This chain 3 counts for a first double crochet. Now here in the magic circle make 11 double crochets in total. Yarn over and the hook in the magic circle. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over and pull for 2. That's 1. Yarn over, back in that same magic circle. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, yarn over, pull for 2. That's 2. 11 in total. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And 11. With your first chain 3 counts for a first double crochet, you have now 12 double crochets in the magic circle. We close the magic circle to pull on that short tail. And then on the top of your first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch, you make 1 slip stitch. Yarn over, pull through, then pull through. Round 2. In this round we make 12 popcorn stitches in total with between and chain 2. And the first popcorn stitch is a little bit different than the rest of it. We start with a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet. Now you go back here in that same stitch where you make in that previous round a slip stitch. You work 4 double crochets all in that same stitch. Yarn over, back into that same stitch and make a double crochet. That's 1. Back in that same stitch, 2. Back in that same stitch for a third. And back in that same stitch. Now we have here with your first chain 3 in the beginning, 5 double crochets. All in that same first stitch. We're going to close that popcorn. You make a little loop. And then go out with your hook and then into that first chain three, in the third chain stitch, you go in with your hook like this, then place the loop back on the hook, close, pull through that first stitch on the hook, and this is your first popcorn. Now make a chain two, one and two. We go to the next stitch, and in that stitch you make a new popcorn stitch of 5 double crochets, all in that same stitch. Into the next stitch, you work one, two, three, four, and 5 double crochets, all in that same stitch. Make a little loop out with your hook, then in the top of the first double crochet of that 5, you on the top, under through that V stitch, then the loop goes back on the hook, pulled close, and then pull through that first double crochet. Then make a chain two. And this popcorn stitch, and then a chain two, is the repeat of this round. I'll show you once more. We make 12 popcorn stitches in total. Yarn over, and the hook into the next stitch, make 5 double crochets in that same stitch. It's one, two, three, four, and 5. Make a loop, go back to the first double crochet of the group of 5, on the top, on the through that V stitch, loop goes back on the hook, pull through the first stitch, and then make a chain two. 3 popcorn stitches complete. We make 12 in total. Work so all the way around, and I see you back here in the beginning. I'm all the way around, 12 popcorn stitches in total, and after the last popcorn stitch you make also a chain 2. We close with a slip stitch in the first chain stitch after that first popcorn. We have here 2 chain stitches, and here in the first chain stitch, go in with your hook, grab your yarn, pull through, and then pull through. And we make also one slip stitch here in the first chain 2 space between the first 2 popcorn stitches. Go in that space, grab your yarn, pull up, and then pull through. In round 2 we start to work the square. We start with a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Now here back in that same chain 2 space where you make that slip stitch, make 2 more double crochets in that space. It's 1 and 2. Now we have here 3 double crochets in total with your first chain 3. We make a corner, chain 2, and now go back in that same space with another 3 double crochets. That's 1, 2, and 3. We have here in the first chain 2 space 3 double crochets, chain 2, 3 double crochets, all in that same space to complete your first corner. We make a straight side, skip over the next popcorn to the next chain 2 space. In that space make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. We do this again, skip over the next popcorn, and then in the next chain 2 space, make 3 double crochets in that same space. It's 1, 2, and 3. This is your straight side. We work again into the next chain 2 space, a corner. Skip over the next popcorn, into the next chain 2 space, make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, chain 2, 1, 2, and back in that same space, 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3 for your second corner. Straight side into the next chain 2 space, 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3 into the next chain 2 space, 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3, and then into the next chain 2 space, make a new corner. 3 double crochets in that chain 2 space, then in chain 2, 3 double crochets back in that same space. So we work all the way around. Work in the next 2 chain 2 spaces, 3 double crochets, then make a corner, and then in the last 2 chain spaces, make a straight side of 3 double crochets. I'll see you back here in the beginning. And this is how it looks like if you work all the way around. Your first corner, then 2 times 3 double crochets, corner, 2 times 3 double crochets, corner, 2 times 3 double crochets, corner, 2 times 3 double crochets. Now we make a slip stitch on the top of the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the third chain stitch. Go in that stitch, grab your yarn, pull through, and then pull through. Now on the top of the next 2 double crochets for the chain 2 corner space, we make 1 slip stitch. Go under through that whole stitch, that V stitch on the top of the double crochet. Grab your yarn, pull through, and then pull through. Make that stitch not too tight. Into the next stitch, also under through that whole V stitch, grab your yarn, pull through, and pull through. And we make also a slip stitch into the chain 2 corner space. In that space, not in that stitch, but in that space, grab your yarn, pull through, and pull through. Turn your work upside down and we start with a first double crochet, that's a chain 3. It's 1, 2, and 3. Now we skip here the first group in the corner of 3 double crochets, and then between the next group of 3 double crochets and that corner, in that space here, in this gap here, we make a new group of 3 double crochets. Yarn over, skip the 3 double crochet, and then here in that space, make a new group of 3 doubles. It's 1, 2, and 3. Now we have here this. It's 1 double crochet, and then a group of 3 double crochets. We skip the next group of 3 double crochets, then yarn over, and then here in that next space, in that next gap, make a new group of 3 double crochets. Spun, 2, and 3. We do this again. Yarn over, skip the next group of 3 double crochet, and then here in the next space, make a new group of 3 double crochets. One, 2, and 3. Yarn over, skip the next group of 3 double crochets, and now here in that chain 2 corner space, we make a new corner. 3 double crochets in that chain 2 corner space. 1, 2, and 3. Then make a chain 2. 1, 2. Back in that same chain 2 corner space with another 3 double crochets. For a new corner. Yarn over. Skip the next 3 double crochets, and then here in the next space and next gap, a new group of 3 doubles. 1, 2, and 3. And again, skip the next group of 3 double crochets in the next space. 3 double crochets in that space. And we do this again. Skip the next 3 double crochets, 3 double crochets in the next space, skip the next 3 double crochets, and now here in the next chain 2 corner space we make only 1 double crochet. In that space, 1 double crochet. Here in this second corner we have 1 double crochet. And also here in the first corner where we start, we make that chain 3 counts also for a first double crochet. Here's 1 double crochet, and here is 1 double crochet. For the next round, we turn our work, and we're facing now to the front of the flower, and we start with a first double crochet, that's in chain 3. So 1, 2, and 3. Now here in that space between the first group of 3 double crochets and that first double crochet, here in this little space here, we make 2 double crochets in that space. That's 1 and 2. So we have here in the beginning of the square 1 group of 3 double crochet. Yarn over, skip the next 3 double crochets, and now here in the next space make 3 double crochets. We do this 2 more times. Yarn over, skip the next 3 double crochets. A new group of 3 double crochets in the next space. Skip the next 3 double crochets. And a new group of 3 double crochets in the next space. Now we skip here the next 3 double crochets, and then in that chain 2 corner space we make a new corner. 3 double crochets in that corner space. 1, 2, 3, chain 2, 3 double crochets back in that same chain 2 corner space. Into the next 3 spaces, make 1 new group of 3 double crochet. To the next space, to the next space. And now you're in the last space between the 3 double crochets and the 1 double crochet. In this space here, we make also 1 group of 3 double crochets in that last space. So we have on this side a group of 3 double crochets, and also here in the beginning we have a group of 3 double crochets. The next round, turn your work upside down and we start all over again. Make a chain 3, counts for a first double crochet. Now we skip here the first group of 3 double crochets and then in the next space make 1 new group of 3 double crochet. Then we work also in the next 3 spaces a new group of 3 double crochets. Then here in the chain 2 corner space make a new corner, 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet. Then in the next 4 spaces make 1 new group of 3 double crochet, and then I see you back here in the beginning. So we have to make 1 more double crochet on the top of the first double crochet here. I worked all my stitches, here's the corner, and then 4 groups of 3 double crochets. Now we have to make 1 more double crochet on the top of the first double crochet. Yarn over, and so you can the top of the first, go through that stitch, and make 1 double crochet. We have here in the on the end 1 double crochet and also in the beginning 1 double crochet. Turn our work. You're facing at the flower. And we start with a chain 3. Counts for a first double crochet, and now between the first double crochet here in the beginning and the 3 double crochets in that space, make 2 more double crochets. So we have here in the beginning 1 group of 3 double crochet. Now into the next 4 spaces, make a new group of 3 double crochets. Then here in the corner, a new corner, 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet. Into the next 5 spaces, a new group of 3 double crochets. I made all my stitches. Now we have here in the beginning a group of 3 double crochets and on the end a group of 3 double crochets. Turn your work upside down and we start with a first double crochet, that's a chain 3. We skip over the next 3 double crochets and make in that next space a new group. And so we work to the other side. We make now in the next 4 spaces a new group of 3 double crochets. Then in the corner, a new corner. Then in the next 5 spaces, a new group of 3 double crochets. And then here on the top of the first double crochet, we make only 1 double crochet. I made all my stitches. I have to make 1 more double crochet on the top of the first group here. one double crochet here in the last double crochet on the top. Like this. So we have here one more double crochet and also here in the beginning one double crochet. We start on the final round. Turn your work so you look at the flower here on the front. And we start with a chain 3, counts for a double crochet. Now make here in that first space between the 3 double crochets and the 1 double crochet, 2 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. This is the first half of a corner here. We work in this round all the way around, and then if we all the way around, we make here in that same space another 3 double crochet and then a chain 2. Now make in every 5 spaces a new group of 3 double crochet and then a corner in this corner here. 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet. Then in the next 5 spaces also one group of 3 double crochets. Work all these stitches and I'll see you back here. I work the stitches of 2 sides. I start here with a first group of 3 double crochet and that's the half of a corner. Then we made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times a group of 3 double crochets. Then a new corner of 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet. And then also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 groups of 3 double crochets in the next 5 spaces. Into the next space, and that's in that chain 3 here, in the beginning, we make a new corner. Yarn over, go over the 3 double crochets, and then here in that chain 3 space, make 3 double crochet, it's 1, 2, and 3, then a chain 2, go back in that same space with another 3 double crochets to complete your second corner. Then we skip here over the next 3 double crochets. Then in the next chain 3 space, or in the next double crochet, around that double crochet, make a new group of 3 doubles. So 1. We do this again. Skip those 3 double crochets here, and then here in the next space also 3 double crochets. Now we have here the corner. That chain 2 corner space, we skip that space. We go over the next 3 double crochets, and then between the next 3 double crochets, this space here, then we make a new group of 3 double crochet. This is the space where we work in the 3 double crochets. Here's the chain 2 corner space. We skip that space. Go over the next 3 double crochets. And then make 3 doubles. And skip the next 3 double crochet, in the next space, 3 double crochet, in that same space. And once more, skip the next 3 double crochets and make a new group. So we have also 5 groups of 3 double crochets on this side too. After that corner here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then in the next space, the chain to corner space, we make a new corner. At the same way, 3 double crochet, chain 2, my yarns from the hook, yes, chain 2, that's 2. Then back in that same chain 2 corner space, 3 doubles. Skip the next 3 double crochet and make a new group in the next space. It's 1, 2, and 3. We do this again, skip the next 3 doubles and make a new group of 3 doubles. Skip the next 3 doubles and make a new group. Now we skip here that chain 2 space of the corner, this space here, and we go to the next space around that double crochet here. 3 double crochets around that double crochet. Skip the next 3 double crochets and then in the next space a new 3 double crochet. Now we have also 5 double crochets after that corner here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 groups of 3 double crochets. That means that we make here in the next space of around that double crochet a next corner. We have made in the beginning a chain 3, count for a double crochet and then work 2 double crochets in that space. In that same space we make that corner complete. Make 3 double crochets in that space. And then we have to make a chain 2. 1, 2. We are all the way around. Now we cut the yarn and make an invisible join in the beginning. Cut your yarn not too short. And then open up that stitch. Pull your hook all the way up, like this. And now we grab the needle. And I zoom a little bit in, so you can see what I'm going to do. With the needle, we skip the first double crochet, that's the chain 3 in the beginning. The next double crochet, the second double crochet, on the top you see that little V. Go under through that V, from the front to the back. Then pull through. Now you make that stitch complete to work here in the middle of that second chain. In the middle, go through. And pull through. This here is your invisible join. Now on the back, I make a little knot, go under through one little thread, pull through, not too tight, for a second time under through that same little piece of thread, now make a little loop, then go with the needle into that loop, and then pull. Now you have made a little knot here on the back. Now only in the back of the stitches of our work we weave in that tail, also to the other side, like this. It's only through the back of the stitches. And this. Now here, that magic circle tail, pull to close. And also we make a little knot here in the beginning, under through one thread. For a second time, make a little knot and then weave in. Only in the back of the stitches. And one to the other side. Now we cut off both tails. And then the square is complete. The size of the square must be 12 by 12 centimeters. And now you have to make 15 more of these same squares, 16 in total. Place the square against each other, 4 in a row. Place the flower as you wish. Let's start joining all the squares together, and we start with the first two, then number 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. But we start with square number 1 and 2. I made a slip knot on the hook, and then we start with square number 1 and 2. We place it together like this. And we start in a chain 1 of the chain 2 here in the corner. We have here a 3 double crochet, then a chain 2. And then in the second chain, we go with the hook into the only in the back loop of that whole stitch. Like this. Now we place the yarn under our work. Like this, and then in square number 2 we have here the first group of 3 double crochet after that chain 2 corner space, 1 and 2. In the second you go into the back loop of that whole stitch like this. Now your working tail is under your work, yarn over the hook, and then pull through the 3 stitches on your hook. Like this. Now we go to the next 2 stitches. The first double crochet after the chain 2, then only in the back loop of that whole stitch. This is the V stitch. This is the whole stitch. This here is the front loop of the stitch. But we work only in the back loop of the stitch. Also, this first double crochet here after that chain 2 corner space. On the top of that double crochet, only in the back loop of that whole stitch. Yarn over and then pull through all the 3 loops on the hook. Go to the next stitch, only in the back loop of that stitch. in the back loop of the stitch, yarn over and pull through all the three loops on the hook. Make those stitches not too tight. If you work too tight, then grab one bigger, larger crochet hook. Then into the next stitch and into the next stitch, only in the back loop, yarn over and pull through all the loops. So you work all these stitches together till next corner, and then after that third double crochet in the group of three, you work also one join stitch in the chain stitch after that last group. Also here, after that last group of the three double crochets, you work also a join stitch in the chain stitch after that group of three, and then I see you back. Work all these stitches to the other side. I work all the stitches to the other side, and I have to make one more join stitch in the chain stitch after the two groups of three double crochets of both squares, also only in the back loop. Now I worked all the stitches together. We don't cut the yarn. We place the next two squares, number 3 and 4, next to the first two squares, and then we go further. At the same way, here's the corner, the chain two corner, and then the chain stitch for the group of three double crochets, that's the place where we start. Then also this square here under, here's the corner, the chain two space, and then here in the chain for the three double crochet group, go in with your hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops on the hook. And then into the next stitch. And this is the way how we join all the squares together. Join like this all the squares together. If you're done with the third and the fourth square, then we place the square number 5 and 6 like this, and then jump over to the next two squares and also number 7 and 8. Join all the stitches. Also here, after the last group of three double crochets, and also here in the chain stitch after that. So work all the join stitches from here to the end of here, and then we place the next four squares to our work like this, and then join all these stitches also like this here. And then when you complete with that row, you join all the last four squares like this, also at the same way. Work all these squares like this together. I see you back when you work the four join rows like this here. Then we turn our work and then we make the crossover stitches. When you have crocheted the 4 rows of squares together, turn your work a quarter. Now work the squares together at the same way and then start here with the first 2 squares. Then I show you how to work over to the next 2 squares. I start here with a slip knot on the hook and I start with the first join stitch in the chain stitch for the first group of 3 double crochets. Then I make all the join stitches to the next corner, and then I have to make 1 more join stitch after the last group of 3 double crochets, also in that chain stitch, in this stitch here, also here in the square here under, after the 3 double crochets in that chain stitch, after that 3 double crochets. And your working space is now very tiny. Let's see if I can get in that stitch. Yes, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through all the loops on the hook. Before we jump over to the next 2 squares, we make simple 1 chain. 1 chain stitch. Now we skip over to the next 2 squares and we work our first join stitch in the chain stitch for the first group of 3 double crochet, only in the back loop. It's a little bit tricky. Get in that stitch, yes. Also, in the next square here under, in the chain stitch for the first group of 3 double crochets in the back loop. The working tail is under our work, yarn over and pull through the 3 loops on the hook. And this is the way how we cross over to the next 2 squares. So join all these stitches, then work your last join stitch in the chain after the last group of 3 double crochets. Then to cross over, make 1 chain stitch, then work your first join stitch in the next 2 squares in the chain stitches for the groups of 3 double crochets. If you're done with this, then you work also the second line at the same way, and also at the same way the third line. And join all the squares together, and then we have to make 1 more round. I made a slip knot back on the hook and we start in a chain 2 corner space, and we make in that space a standing double crochet. The yarn is on the hook, then yarn over. Enter your hook in a chain 2 corner space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. This is a standing double crochet. Now back in that same chain 2 corner space, we make 2 more double crochets in that space. That's 1 and 2. Now we work in every stitch 1 double crochet. Your first stitch is here, that first double crochet of the group of 3. On the top, on the 2, that V stitch, make 1 double. then into the next stitch. Under through that whole V stitch, make one double, and into the next stitch. Work in every stitch one double crochet, and I show you how to skip over to the next square. And I made here my last double crochet on the top of the last double crochet of the group of three for the chain two corner space. What we're going to do now is we make one double crochet here in that chain two corner space, in that space. And now we work into the same corner space and into the next corner space, two double crochet together. And we work also around that tail here. Yarn over, back in that same chain two corner space. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for two. Now you stop, yarn over, enter hook into the next square in the next chain two corner space. Grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, and pull for two. Now you have three loops on the hook, two not complete double crochets. We work those two double crochets together. Yarn over and pull through three loops in one go. Go back into that same chain two corner space with another double crochet. And this is how we cross over to the next square. Your working tail is on the back of the square and you work around that tail. The first double crochet of the group of three, that's the first double crochet here that you work. And now in every stitch, one double crochet till you get to the next corner. And work around that tail on the back. In every stitch, one double crochet. So if you here in the next corner of that chain two corner space, we work one double crochet in that space, and then back in that same space and into the next space of the next square in the chain two corner space, you work two double crochet together. Then go back in the next space of that next square of the chain two and make one more double crochet in that same space. You work around the tail and make in every stitch one double crochet. If you're here in the point in that chain two, you work a new corner of three double crochet in that chain two corner space. You work like this all the way around. I see you back in the beginning on the top of the second double crochet that we work here in the beginning. We made one invisible join. I'm all the way around, make all my stitches, and I cut the yarn, open up that stitch, and make an invisible join in the beginning. And we skip the first double crochet, that's the standing double crochet. We skip that stitch, we go to the next stitch. Then on the top, under to that V, the front to the back, pull through. Then you go to the last double crochet that you work here, the last double crochet, and then on the top, only in the back loop, and pull through. This here is your invisible join. Now on the back, make a little knot and weave both tails in on the back of the stitches. I have here my cushion cover and I place the big granny square on top of it, like this. And I left a little bit of the color of the cover here, of the outside. Now with a small yarn and a small needle, with a sharp point, you make all the way around small stitches around each double crochet and through the cushion cover. Make all these stitches all the way around and then we're done. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!